All right, peace, fam, man. You wouldn't believe how hard it is to do a show, man. I'm sitting up here, stuck in limbo, because I put my phone on the charger last night, and guess what? It's not charged. I decided my computer, I wake up my computer to do an automatic update. Guess what? I didn't give it permission to do that. I'm not exactly happy with what's going on here. And so I'm streaming live on, that's one of the changes that I made. Because I'm thinking, I said, I have to have a way that I could get in touch with my people to let them know that something is going on. And I know that once I start streaming live, there's an automatic link that goes out to my Facebook page. But I just need to let my, I need to get on here and let my people know. So I'm about to send out a text, and we about to do it, family. Because I guess we're going to have to move into the ghost protocols. You know what I'm saying? Because this is not making any sense. So now I'm live up on Facebook. We won't be doing Instagram today. Actually, I think I may start doing the radio show like this since I can't get Black Talk. Black Spot to act right at this point in time. So maybe I will start recording, not recording, but doing my show live on the Spreaker app. And I'll run everything through my computer. But what we're about to do right now, family, is y'all about to see me do my little thing with this super phone. I'm about to do this thing with the super phone real quick. Make sure that all of the family that is supposed to be here is here. Thanks to the two people that showed up. Sorry I'm late. I'm sitting up here explaining because right now I'm streaming on Spreaker. Great Ujima, Brother Kwame. I don't know who else is out there. That's probably Anubis. I want to send my apologies because when I woke up this morning, my phone wasn't charged. My computer automatically went into an automatic update. I don't understand it. But then I do understand it, right? My camera on the wrong side of the thing because I got to still send out the messages on the super phone. And I ain't got the sound effects because Spreaker ain't coming up right now. But here goes Spreaker. So, you know, we're going to be able to get it all moving. And I want to get up as soon as possible, man, because I was up. I was on time. I even got Cleve up. I'm sitting up here. I had to wait. I had to wait for the computer to reboot. And I'm sitting up here like, this is ridiculous. But no, it's not ridiculous. This is what happens in a world that is not your own. Let me say that again. This is what happens. We meet tomorrow night. Nah. I thought we was going to meet on the 21st. Well, actually, that's with the elders, so we need to do our meeting. But this week is going to be horrible because of the Black Panther event and Simba and Simpsa coming up and the father-daughter dance over at the school. So this week is horrible. So we will start the meeting next week, but we're going to meet on the 21st with the elders. To kind of start hashing out some of that stuff, and you could do that one over the phone, and then we'll be up with the I almost said it. We'll be up with the Ujima meetings on next Ujima. We'll just start that Ujima meetings next Ujima. Is that cool? And then, like I said, if you got some stuff you need to cover, feel free to hit me up. Okay, feel free to hit me up, and we could go and chop it up. But let me send out this message on. So you know, one of the challenges with this super phone piece is that people hear from you, right? You know, even though they gave you their number, and they when my picture pop up, you know. Because on the app, I have a picture that pops up while I'm trying to, trying to get you to get your information. And people will not understand to click the link, don't want to click the link, because there's so many traps out here at this point in time for them that they will not even think about. Look it up with me. Then I got, I'm sitting up there looking all dusty. I got my little hat, my little skull cap on, looking at you. You know what I'm saying? Like, what's up? Why you ain't sign up? You know what I'm saying? And the whole piece is, one, just like with my writings, I want people to look at what I do and feel that they can do what I'm doing. And I don't know if y'all feel that. My books, I'm not super pressed about the mistakes in my books because I want people to feel that they could do what I did. I'm not the best writer in the world. My thoughts don't flow all in a logical order. But, you know what I'm saying? I'm willing to put my ideas down. And if somebody who writes the way that I do is willing to put their thoughts down, I will hope that you would feel that you could do the same thing and that you have the right to do the same thing. You know what I'm saying? Because my whole piece is we got a lot of brilliant people sitting on the sidelines just like waiting for some. It's almost like waiting for permission. And it's like, cool, let me go and I'll do it first. I don't mind. Shouts out to Brother Anubis. But you already spoke with them concerning the text. So what is it to do to have short-term memory? Well, yeah. Because, right now, like I said, but this world is ruled by fear. Fear. You know what I'm saying? So it's like you get a strange text message, even though it got my picture on it, right? The only thing I'm saying is click the link so that you could fill out my phone book. It's threatening. You understand what I'm saying? So it's like, it's different. You know, and different things aren't good in our community, I guess. Cleveland.
Yeah.
Boy, you over there asleep. Don't you make me get up. So you need to sit up. I'm sorry. Real life over here, Gianni. Please join us for the toast. Now, I had to put this on Facebook for the new people. Search Gianni. Me journey. Become a daily toaster. I need to, but also I need to start hyping up this podcast as well, because I like the podcast a whole lot. Who else on there? Who that? Shit, I work for NASA. There ain't a thing they don't know about me to the color of my undergarments. And hell, I don't even know that. See, and that's the piece. That's the piece that bothers me, because some of us are so secret when in fact we're not. Because if you have a Facebook account, if you have a Google account, if you have all these accounts, you know what I'm saying? You ain't hiding. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you're not. If you have a cell phone, you're not hiding. So, I'm a brother asked you for some information, and we got problems. Let me see. Please join us for the toast on Facebook. Search Gianni Journey. Become a daily toaster. We are live now. Let's see if that works. Y'all let me know if y'all get this text. This is a whack text, but hey, it's all I got to work with at this point in time. But hey, we do got 19 people who like, hey, I'm with it. Send me the text. I say, okay. Because when people come in and say, hey, I want to do the daily toast. I say, are you sure? You know what I'm saying? I mean, because, you know, we up at 5:15. Some of us up earlier than that. You know what I'm saying? Toasting. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. You know what I'm saying? I just want to be sure. Because there's nothing worse than getting a text at 5 o'clock in the morning. You know what I'm saying? In fact, they can use the info from all those accounts to predict your behavior. Remember the guy who spoke on hacking the human being from the mind to the body and beyond? Word. That's what I'm talking about. You know what I'm saying? And the issue that I'm saying is we need to start learning how to use that stuff ourselves. We need to start gathering our data. We need to start doing it, man, because it's like, you know, going through Destruction of Black Civilization again. We did a lot of running. I just want to say that. Yeah, we had individuals that stayed and fought. But we did a lot of running and strategic retreats, and we just wanted to avoid problems. We just wanted to keep the peace because there's plenty. I mean, we do the same thing with hip-hop. We did the same thing with jazz. It's like we got plenty of creativity, and we did the same thing we're doing with our talent right now, the same thing we're doing with our mental ideas right now, we did with our land. And I'm saying that to say, brother, it's like when it comes to us dealing with us, we might need to kind of turn up the heat and really start finding out who's with us and who's against us. We really might need to start really making people feel uncomfortable, man. Because listen, history shows. Because check this out, man. I'm listening to Chancellor Williams. And Chancellor Williams lays out the whole strategy, right? And we had issues with Asians, right? West Asians, Central Asians, East Asians, all trying to move in and take what we had. And we just kind of, we fought them, and then we would move to the interior. And they started populating the ports, taking control of the ports. And the very same thing that's happening there, you can see happening in Africa right now. Who is paying for the infrastructure? Who is buying up Africa? And as a matter of fact, it's the same thing that's happening in Europe. Because right now they got this beltway or this belt thing that they're building. And China is going around, they buying ports. And what they do is, the strategy is that you get a port city and you start populating that port city, and you populate that port city till eventually you got a stronghold that in order for them to get you out, they have to declare war. One is one belt, one road policy. All right. Anubis says, exactly, I study a little bit of human behavioral patterns at university, and the results were pretty much always the same. Whenever we did test groups, exactly, etc. I just got the text, by the way, cool. All right, so we know the text is going out. Let's go on and get the YouTube up. Ain't this something? I got to walk y'all through all the steps with me. Actually, we won't even put YouTube on. What we going to do is what we usually do before this time. But, because I'm kind of parched. How about you? China is not only buying up the infrastructure and supporting the infrastructure in Africa, but they're also buying up ports in Europe, and that's causing a lot of problems, right? Because the West Asians understands the East Asian strategy, because it's a strategy that they have used for a very long time, and it's one that we need to be aware of, family. You do not, like, for example, a black family will sell their land for short-term gains. This, I mean, we gave up land for short-term peace. We gave up land because we felt that we was blessed enough and something better will pop out. And now we done been moving and we've been moving and we've been surrendering. Some of us been fighting and, you know what I'm saying? And we've been looking for peace for a long time. Now we got snatched and moved all the way across the seas, family. And it's time for that shit to stop, because we ain't got nowhere else to go. We ain't got nowhere else to go. You know what I'm saying? It's time for us to really start getting our minds together, start using this principle of Ujima, collective work and responsibility. We need to start sounding the war horn. We need to start sounding the drum beats, the heartbeat of the nation. And, you know, because I was thinking very seriously, as I usually do. You know, I'm always on some nation building shit. This is what causes a lot of problems in my life, right? I'm saying, how can I bring people together here, at least here in Columbus, develop a model that could be used, right? But before we get into that, I need to let you know you are now listening to GIMA Journey Media. This is the Daily Toast, a Heart of a Simba production, where we strive to blow up your old paradigms. Yeah, I think that I do like having streaming the podcast live. I really enjoy it. So I will use the tablet for that rather than use it for Instagram. So the sound for, hopefully the sound is clear. Not, I apologize, Spreaker. And I'm glad y'all got y'all text message. So we're going to finish up our water. We're going to do our toast. But getting back. So I've been thinking, how can we start getting our folks together? And I started looking and reading this book once again, and then thinking about my experience when I went over to Ghana. One of the things that was always prevalent, and one of the things I'm constantly running into when I'm reading about our culture, is the marketplace. Build a marketplace. And I'm putting some mental energy into that. Building a marketplace. See, because y'all do know back in the day, marketplaces were portable. Marketplaces were just started at random spots, and sometimes it would stick and it would build and people would come and set up, right? Watch me, fam. It's about to go down. Get ready, Kwame, because we got some work to do, my friend. Because I'm about to put this whole... Look, I got this plan. And like I said, we about to put our heads together. And we about to have a grand marketplace where people could come. When they come, they could shop. And not just find shea butter and kente cloth. But, you know, what about those families that might have old clothes to sell? Or that family that might like to knit, or that artist that might have a portrait, right? Or that artist that might want to sell their CDs, and their jazz musician or something that we could play and listen to at the place, and, you know, or actually have them perform. I'm not playing, man. I'm not playing with this, right? So Go and finish up your water, family. This Kaumba, we will be in the house on Olden Tangi River Road over at the Lennox. We will be watching Black Panther together. And it looked like we may have a nice size studio or theater where we could go on and have a discussion. Oh, we need inventors, hobbyists, we need artists, we need, you know what I'm saying, people that come and at least have a little place to set up a little business space. You know what I'm saying? Little, you know what I'm saying? Just for a day. So that people know they out there. You know what I'm saying? Because it's like, then that brings people out. You know what I'm saying? Because you're going to have everybody, you know, I'm going to be doing this weekend, blah, 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 or whatever. Are you guys watching it? No. IMAX is going to be about, we would have to sell them tickets $30 a piece. I'm not, no. And I don't want nobody, I don't want to be that close to no damn movie anyway. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's like, it's bad enough now. The movies is so clear right now. So I couldn't imagine really being surrounded. You know what I'm saying? You know. And then, yet I don't even know the whole story of the Black Panther at this point in time. So I want to make sure I like it before I get immersed in it. You know what I'm saying? Because the commercials look good. But hell, the commercial for The Last Jedi look good too. I mean, so hey, you know, we all can be fooled, right? Shouts out to Miss Navita Nelson. Thank you for joining us. Sorry the text came late. Everything was moving slow, so I had to kind of change the setup a little bit on the spur of the moment. Brother Kwame and Brother Nuba sat with me while I set up here and set this stuff up. So we're about to get this toast on. As you hear, the family is growing. And the way, if you read the text message, you see I sent it out so that new people would know where to find us, because I got people like, where is that? What's going on? You know what I'm saying? I'm like, wow, okay. So they're not even on Gianni Journey. And then also, we're going to have to start doing some stuff with the whole Kwanzaa 365 site and Facebook page. So here we go. Are you guys? No, not on IMAX. Okay, cool. So all of the texts went out. Navita, did you get your text? Let's see. I want y'all to see it. I want to see if y'all can hear that. Hold on. Woo! Man, I love this ambrosia, man. Y'all hear that? Y'all hear that? Listen. Y'all hear that? Now, this is that Kwame here. I'm going to need a little bit of energy today. My car is acting up. I got to get it fixed before Nia, because I got to take my girls to the dance. Plus some other things. I can see all the roots and stuff in here. So, family, right now, we're going to toast the creator by whatever name you choose to call that creator. We call that great force, that force that started it all, right? We salute the first ancestor, and we lift up our glasses, and we say, Ashe. From there, without any further ado, because I know that's what y'all come for. Come for the ancestors. Now for Brother Hatem running his mouth. Come for those ancestors. So we want to make sure we send those shots, those proper shots out to those upon whose shoulder we stand. And I thank y'all for allowing me to read your ancestors' names on the list. So We'll start off. Miles Brown, Miss Ann, Robin the Tech Center, David, Turner Brown, Senior, Rosalie Tilly, Georgia William Walter, Christopher Annie Gadsden, Aunt Lena, Uncle Chris, Aunt Fiend, Cleveland and Geneva Brown, Margaret Ellis, Wash Ellis, Cecil Ellis, Alvaro Brown, Gina Gaines, Herman Brown the Second, Barbara Twiggs. Cleveland, wake up. Are you asleep? Huh?
No.
Well, you gonna give me my time. Barbara Twiggs, Wash Ellis Jr., Katie Ellis, Nikki Ellis, Jamon Jones, Jeremiah Toppin, John Fallard, Montague Pimentel, No More X, Pet Mile Rob, Malika Fakur, Dr. Marianne Williams, Kojo Kamau, Elder Farmer, Elder Millie Dixon, Tony Clark, Pastor Yusuf Western, Elder Ogeny, Elder Ron Coleman, Elder Robert Donaldson, Alfred Brofro, Hector Jr., Jay Edwards, Carlisle Harris, Grace Lundy, Inez Harris, William Bill Monks, Phyllis Rose, Sterling and Lucy Wright, Derek L. Pullian, the Lester Brothers, Miss Edith Brooks Crawley, Miss Marie Nelson, Mr. Frederick Crawley Sr., Miss Jerry Brunson, Mr. Alonzo Johnson, Miss Marie McDowell, Janice Foster, Charles Jordan, Kale Smith, Walter Smith, Richard Triggs, Francis Johnson, Mary Franklin, Jimmy Williams, Daniel Ford, George Gibson, Nana Loretta Clark, Inez McCray, Fritz Clark, Frankie Justice, Katie Justice, Derek Randleman, Virginia Rogers, Reverend Jane Smith, Lois Henderson, Calvin Spratling, Mary Elizabeth Walker, Raymond Walker Sr., Sarah Jane Carter, Michael Ford Jr., Kellen D. Russell, Susan B. Smith, Teresa Clay, Melvin Dale Hodge Jr., Herman Copeland, Mildred Copeland, Jenny Clay, Bird Beatty, Sarah Whale, Levita Farmer, Igosa Sue, Shell Harvey, Aunt Charmaine, Aunt Evelyn, Theolis Hasbury, Harvey Hasbury Sr., Leonard Dickinson, T.C. Islam, Terrell Dunbar, Will Thomas, Sarah Berry, Mark Walsh, Merle B. Thornton, Pearl G. Thornton, Ida Johnson, Florence M. Carter, Joanne Thornton, Erica Trisha Lewis, Juanita Wright, Robert Wright, George Wright, Mary Eliza Frederick Davis, Mary Elizabeth Rogers, Mary Esther Keach Larice, Linda Watson Hammonds, Jarrell Giles Watson, Sparrow, Slimmy, Selvin Lewis, Andrew Holmes, Pearl Moore, Percy Moore Jr., Mildred Owens, Booker T. Bolton, Charlie Hunt, Sammy Stover, Hilda Pearson, Sturgeon Thornton, Richard Thornton, Lavinia Hall, Freeman Bankster, Mary Moss, Ophelia Peacock, Willie Thornton, Napoleon Kennedy, Mark Ramsey, Paul Ramsey, Matt Ramsey, David Ramsey, Charles E. Thornton, Frankie Quills, Urania Thornton, Bernice Quills, Ernestine Jackson, Frankie Johnson, Teresa Mormon, Leon Johnson, Charles Bell, Vivian Ramsey, S.E. Johnson, Derrita Johnson, Leon Johnson, James W. West Sr., James Parham, Dana Jones, Henry Worlds, James Farmer, Mary Chavez, Leon Grace, Bessie Johnson, Hattie Levester, Mary Moreland, Paul Moreland, Elder Caleb, Rosemary Martineer, Elder Imhotep Wellman, Fred Douglas Triggs Sr., Delma Triggs, Thomas and Lula Berry, Lacey Eleanor Howe, Franklin Russell and Davis, Fred Douglas Triggs II, Vina Triggs, Reverend Eddie Moore, Helen Fuller, Eugene Jackson Sr., Richard Ellis, Silas Alexander, Charles Maxwell, Percy May Alexander, Arthur Reynolds, Stanley Lockhart, Ricky Lockhart, William Lockhart, Woodrow Lockhart, Brenda Porter, Deacon Hargrove, Carl Sawyer, Andrew Parker, Doris Donald, Ellis Murphy, Brother Nubis added to his list, Gene Holmes, Dana Jones, Peter Charles, Christy Nichols, Cardinal Robinson, Rose Mary Charles, Sister Teandres, salutes her ancestors, Ada Pearl, Bob Ingalls, Jack Wallace, Warren P. Finch, Tim Ingalls, Aunt Audrey Finch, William Billingsley Jr., Brother Sensenball, Brother Deshaun, salutes Jennifer Sensenball, Hazel Gadsden, Jerry Brantley, Brian Watson Jr., Kaniko Parsons, Miss Aisha salutes, Stacy Trice, Frank Smith, Mother Bertha, Michael Leonard, David Brown, Miss Ford salutes, Ruth Carter, June Cox, Ruth and Paul Cox, Ronald Irving, Judy Hubbard, Irene Johnson, Francis Boots Jefferson, Dr. D salutes Dan Wilkerson Sr., Miss Jackie salutes Emma McClendon, Brother Kwame added to the community list Jerry Doyle and Amina Robinson. Sister Cynthia reminded us about Brother Shabaka Toure, right? Oh, it wasn't late. I was late sending the text out, but thank you. Sister Madonna salutes her mother Donna Hill and her father Richard Gleavis. Sister Cynthia salutes Lee Irby, Tommy Irby, Boy Irby, Jim Gaucher, George and Haley Johnson, Archie and Margaret Armstead. CeeLo added to her list Archie Beck, Brother Santana sends shots out and salutes Aunt Becca. Elder Greg Arnold salutes Alice Arnold, Arthur Arnold, Hattie Reed, Charles Reed. Sister Shelley I salutes Ula and Andrew Baker, Patricia and Edwin Brooks, Gwendolyn and Bob Hatton, Kimball Vernon, Bradley, Kim, Janie, Harriet Tubman Cates, Spencer Sturgis, Sally Mae Baker, Ethel Baker, Creola Baker, Geneva Baker, Aaron Nino Baby Hatch, Hatch Sr., Mally Miller, Housie Hatch, Dad Cleveland, Mother Gibson. Sturgis. I think we got some other Sturgises on our list. Brother Quabana salutes his father. Well, I don't know who it is. Brother Quabana salutes Alex Nixon. Elder Bowie salutes John Bowie. Janelle Ross salutes Doretha Ross, Riola Ross, Robert Nelson, Francis Stevenson, Leroy Stokes. Elder Ori Pianchi salutes Neely Johnson and Fletcher Swan, Maddie and Charlie Scott. Charles Steffen salutes Vivian Stephenson. Charles Steffenson salutes Vivian Stephenson. Cassandra Holloway salutes Mona Ann. Elder Phyllis salutes Martha Ford Dawson, Big Mama, Nanny Harris, Eva Ford, James Hairston. And Sister Enya salutes Margaret Towns and Mary Williams. As y'all hear, the list is slowly but surely growing. All right, the day is Ujima, and it's the day of collective work and responsibility. Like I said, family, I'm really thinking about this market piece. I'm working it out, seeking the permissions that I need. And we're going to make it happen. We're going to sit down in the meeting. We're going to make it happen. The modic principle of the day is righteousness. The M7 for the day is respect. The color is blue. The hermetic law today is vibration. If you are born on this day and you're male, the name is Kweku. And if you're female, the name is Akua. The African-centered cultural virtue and value system. The Wolof principle today is Yar. Politeness and respect, particularly towards your elders. In a kind, obedience and respect. And in traditional Yoruba, Iluti, teachability. All right? So we got that. All right, family. Now, let's look at these emotionals. Breaking the code. Let's remember those emotions. We know we got power. Like I say at the end of the show, I wish you peace, power, and joy. We know we got those three. Feeling peaceful, joyful, and powerful. If you feel like that, keep on doing what you're doing, right? Or as Elder Joaquin said, keep on keeping on. But if you are mad, ask yourself, how have I been violated, right? And if so, set your limits. Reestablish your boundaries. If you're sad, ask yourself the question, what did I lose? What's the loss? And then ask for the support that you need. Take the space that you need. Take time to grieve and let go. Then if you're scared, right, what's the danger? And then, like I said, be honest. If you need protection, ask for it. Ask for support. Ask for reassurance. You know what I'm saying? Because there's no need for us running around here not using this guidance system called the emotions that we've been taught we're supposed to stay away from, when in fact the emotions are leading us, if we learn how to read them, to the higher part of ourselves, right? No need, you know, so we're going to start having some reminders on the show about, you know, how to deal with these emotions. So we toast those ancestors, my father, and we say Ashe. We salute the moment, and we say Ashe. Now we move to the future. We toast our children, our children's children, onto infinity, and guess what? We say Ashe for near family. We move on, and we salute all of our relations, and we say Ashe. From there, we toast you. Those that take the time to get up and share, you know what I'm saying? Those that took time to stay up with us, we salute you, and we wish you peace, power, and joy. And once again, family, I need to remind you that you are now listening to Giame Journey Media. Anime, get it together. Man, you are now listening to Giame Journey Media. Damn. I mean, these phoenixes, man, I mean, all right, I'm going to stop. Of course, you know, this is Daily Toast. This is the Heart of a Simmer production. Well, we strive to blow up your old paradigms. Family, I toast you. Peace, power, and joy. Have a marvelous day. Peace out.